in your view, what is Goodfriend's legacy?
Well, the legacy here is real simple. This is the conservative end of economics, think John Taylor, Stanford, but particularly the Shadow Open Market Committee. And what's so important is out of the conservatism of the 50s and the 60s, and Joe, the worry about inflation that was there,
yeah,
there was an intellectual architecture that said, this is how we stop inflation. Goodfriend was the young wonder child of that academic movement. Out of Union College, out of Brown, PhD, he immediately got a claim at the Richmond Fed, where he ended up really casting their character. Jeff Lacker mentioned that in his comments this afternoon.
But sort of his intellectual stake that he made on this issue, to a certain extent, might have cost him a job on the Fed.
Absolutely, no question about it. And it goes to Joe's wonderful interview with Senator Warren the other day. She was one of the deserved arch critics of what was grouped as the inflationistas. And Goodfriend defended the group and also stumbled at that hearing for the Fed over where was inflation. And that's been the source of his research here in recent years.
Is that why his nomination just kind of lapsed and didn't really result in the next step?
I think so. There will be speculation. The family has said that he was quite ill, and you wonder about how that played into it in all. But the huge issue here, which you've all covered every day from the beginning of the crisis, is there's going to be inflation. There's going to be inflation. Yeah. He was the intellectual underpinning of so many that were less graceful.
You know, you mentioned the sort of school of thinkers, many of whom were forged intellectually in the 70s with that raging inflation. If you look at the sort of long sweep of history, is this just the sort of inevitable ebb and flow where there's going to be, in your view, a group of people who came of age during the post-crisis,
absolutely,
who will never worry about
this
inflation?
This is conservative and liberal. And let me just suggest Paul Krugman is an arch-liberal and Marvin Goodfriend is more conservative. Their Venn diagram, there was a lot of overlap in what they agreed on. It's not as polarized as the media makes it. Joe, one quick thing with Professor Goodfriend was his profound paper at Jackson Hole a few years ago on negative interest rates. And the last time I spoke to him, I said, Marvin, I don't agree with all your paper. There were some elements that were a raging debate. The Monday after that Jackson Hole, we had four or five people call up demanding to be on the program to go after Marvin on this.
So who's a Goodfriend acolyte? Who should we be watching for to kind of carry the
torch? Oh, that's an interesting question. I think the conservatives are in a quiet, not retreat, but they've been subdued with the low inflation that we have. But you know, the moment inflation comes up,
They'll be back.
Charles Evans at the Chicago Fed has really turned on this, where he was worried, and now you have Charles Evans saying, let's bring up inflation. That's something Professor Goodfriend would have been uncomfortable.
We've still got two vacant seats on the Fed. Do we end up with someone like Goodfriend or someone maybe a little bit
further? That's not an appropriate question for Friday afternoon.
No,
that takes a beverage in my hand.
Okay.
At least. This is a raging debate. You've hit the third rail, Romaine.
All right.
And that this is really important. To a person, everyone would say that Marvin Goodfriend was the best nominee that the president has come up with academically in the construction of monetary theory, with great respect to Vice Chairman Clarida.